I gotta do my intro! Give me a
second! I'm
sorry! Shush! Okay. I can't do it anymore. Welcome to FurMedia, folks, where we provide a voice and a social connection with furries from around the world. My name is Space, and I'm joined by my lovely host,
Punya.
And we welcome you guys to this evening's show. What a wonderful show we're going to have here in just a few minutes. To kind of give you guys a real quick heads up, the picture you're seeing right behind, well, the giant pink Sonic fursuit thing, or hedgehog, yes, that is going to be our first guest, and that's going to be Falky. Say hello, Falky.
Hi. I also like to correct you, I'm not a Sonic character.
Okay. You're a hedgehog?
Yes, I am a hedgehog.
Sorry, I didn't want to say Sonic. I was trying to reference the two in correlation, but it wasn't working. So,
oh, no, it's okay. I'm just messing with you.
So a hedgehog character right there, and she'll be joining us in here in just a second. But to kind of just get everyone up to speed real quick, and of course we'll have those that will be joining in later, I'm sure, as they always are. We're doing our Biggest Little FurCon 2016 convention review. We only do these reviews when one of our staff members ends up going to a convention. We always say take lots of pictures, take lots of videos, get as many people as you can in contact with, grab tons of really cool art, you know, dealers cards and stuff, and then let's talk about it. And so so much happened at this convention. Oh, there we go. I don't know who that is. Oh, yeah, I know who that is. Okay. So much has happened at this convention that it's, I almost feel like one show is just not going to be enough. And we'll just kind of play it by ear. Because if I have to end up doing it, I might do a second part two to this convention, maybe on my own time and not as an actual show itself. But let's go ahead and just dive right in.
AD time.
Did you say baby time?
I said AD time.
Eight after dark time.
No convention is complete without AD time.
there were definitely after dark panels and stuff that I did actually attend one. It was the
Pepper. It's the Drama Llama.
It was the Pepper Coyote and Fox and More after dark show, which was totally worth it.
That's the one I saw. It was amazing.
It was great. But we'll delve into that a little bit more in just a second. Folks, Biggest Little Fur Con is located in Reno, Nevada. And the actual convention itself was held over May 12th through the 15th of 2016. And of course, you're seeing I have to scroll over here because I have forgotten already. And they had a theme last year, which was all about, I think it was...
It's like a utopia, dystopia sort of thing, all led by Prometheus Fair.
Right, exactly. And then this year, and then they brought down like the regime at the end of the convention. So this year they were actually connecting the same theme, but over. So now it was all about factions and who was going to take control over the convention itself. So there was a lot of like spray painted posters and graffiti kind of things all over the place, which was really cool. And then to kind of add to it, I'm pretty sure this is more or less to keep people out of the dealer's den, but I think also it had to do with the theme itself. They had giant chain link fences around the convention itself. Like, I mean, around the dealer's den, so it kind of made it look like it was like, you know, sketchy a little bit. So it really added to the atmosphere. And everyone got these really cool, like, ID cards. You know how everyone gets like convention cards, but this one, like this year, was rad because we'll talk about that in a second because I got a really cool one. There was a lot of people that attended. I think I tweeted it on Twitter and I might have forgotten it already, and I'm so sorry. If someone can link me that, I'm gonna go search for it right now. I guess we can talk about that in a second as soon as I figure it out. So there was a lot that happened. There was a lot of fursuiters. There was a lot of attendees. It was very free-flowing. Nothing seemed to be, like, if there was an issue, you didn't hear about it because that's how well it was taken care of. It was just perfect. So I could talk all about it as much as I want to right now, but we do have a guest on the show, and she only has a certain amount of time. So we're going to go ahead and just delve into you real quick, Falky. How was your con experience overall? If you had to rate it from 1 to 10.
I would say probably a 10. It was great.
Awesome.
Like, I was expecting, I don't know, because the last few ones I've been kind of paying attention to, I've seen like a lot of drama surrounding them. and I did not see anything for this one. I mean, I heard a couple of cases of, like, people getting things stolen, but that was, like, maybe one or two things. And, yeah, I did not have any complaints. Of course, the pre-reg line was a little long, but...
I guess it depends, though. Like, okay, so I heard the pre-reg line was super long, and then I went in, like... Well, I don't know. I guess that's because I went in, like, 8 o'clock, 8 or 9 or whatever, and the line was non-existent. Like, it wasn't even there. And so... They're like, what's your name? And I'm like, Christensen. Because, you know, you have to go by your last name. Not like your real last name, folks. Not like your fake last name. and they're like, here's your stuff. And I totally forgot that I was a sponsor. I thought I just paid, like, regular level. And I swear to God, they... Did you get... What did you get in your pack? What did you pay for? Or no, it doesn't really matter.
I got sponsor. So, okay. Like, a shirt and a bandana.
And what color was your shirt?
It was red and yellow. It kind of was, like, red on one side and kind of faded into yellow.
Okay, we can't be friends.
So. Oh, come on. I thought we had was special. How can you forget after gay baby jail? How could you?
Gay baby jail! Okay, you guys don't know what gay baby jail is, but I have videos of it, and there is now going to be a hashtag gay baby jail that's associated to FurMedia only, hopefully.
Oh my
god.
I've seen it elsewhere before.
Gay baby gel is awesome. I didn't realize it was on that box until you pointed it out, and then I had to go look at it. It's pretty funny. So I think in the sponsor pack we all got a t-shirt, and you were split up into like two to four different factions, and each shirt had a different color. So she had red and yellowish. I think Felix has a red and yellowish. I got a blue. You also got like a poker chip that was custom designed. You also got a bandana. What color was your bandana?
I got the Project Greenlight one, so it was purple with the what was it? Some kind of canine and tiger on the other side.
Okay, so I got the same one. So I got a Project Greenlight as well. And then you also got your tag in there, like your whatever you call it. What do you call those things that you wear around your neck? Clown badge. dang it. And a couple
thing.
Yeah, a thing. And a couple other things. And it wasn't just like, you know, like here's a couple of things, here you get to hold it all. No, it was all like put together perfectly, and then they sealed the bag. So the bag was like clamp sealed shut. So that was cool. Everything was ready to go, which was awesome. I think it moved fairly good, unless you were there like Falky was. Like the line was incredibly huge. For me it was like not huge at all.
Yeah, I was probably in line for a good like hour.
I heard some gnarly like people are just waiting there for like 2 hours, and I'm like a pre-ledge reg line, and you go and you look at the register line and it wasn't even that big because everyone had already pre-reg. So I'm just like, God, I kind of wish I had just, you know, registered instead of pre-reg.
I guess it's always just better to expect a really long line and then be surprised and have it be not there than be like, oh yeah, this is gonna be great, and then find the one that takes 3 hours.
Yeah. What else did you, what was the first thing you did when you got there after you got your con badge and everything?
I just kind of walked around. I was with my boyfriend, and he was in a longer line because of his last name, so I was waiting for him for probably a good 10-20 minutes. But after that, we just kind of walked around. There wasn't too much to do on the first day. We went to a Sons of Prometheus panel. That was cool. Prometheus lives. And he will take back he will end the chaos that has become a BLFC Corp, and it will be remade. But yeah, that was pretty much it. There wasn't too much else to do besides just walk around, see who else is there.
What panels besides that one? Did you attend any other panels?
I was going to, but I kind of lost track of time, so no.
Yeah, I kind of felt like that was the case too. Like, I wanted to attend a couple of panels, but then again, so here was the issue. They had really good events, but you really didn't know about the events until like a few days before the panel or the convention actually started. And to be honest, it wasn't Biggest Little FurCon's fault. Like, for once, it's not a convention's fault. I would have to say that it would be the fault of one singular person, which we won't say who, but they know that they suck for it. took on too much that they could handle, and then decided last second, like literally a month before, oh, I can't do this anymore. It's just too much. I should give this up. Gave it up, and then BLFC and kind of got some other people together and then just threw them into the mix and said, here you go. And I'm just like, oh my God, I feel so bad. So a couple of the panels were kind of like set up as quickly as they could, but they did the best that they could in the situation they had. I don't think a lot of people knew about the actual situation as far as events go. So they did the best that they could in that particular area. And I do applaud them. There's my applause. Yay. Right there. So.
So round of applause for BLFC, everyone.
Good job.
So did you only attend that one panel, or did you go to any others?
Like I said, I just totally lost track of time. There's bunch I wanted to go to, but I just had too much fun.
How was the Fursuit Festival for you?
It was kind of hectic getting in there. It was very just... Our line just kind of dissolved into a large clump of furry, sweaty people. Ew. So once we got in and got the picture after we got the picture, I cannot talk. It was fine. It was fun. They had fans set up, water set up. It was nice. We just kind of hung out.
For those who don't know, the Fursuit Festival is Biggest Little Fur Con's version of a fursuit parade. Because this year their con space was actually a little bit smaller than it was last year, the previous years. I'm not quite sure why that happened, but it did. They didn't have the adequate space or the permission from the hotel to do a parade, even though the Fursuit Festival like line extended way like throughout the bottom part of the hotel. So I'm just like, I don't really understand why they couldn't have done the fursuit parade, but okay, whatever. So they did this giant festival, and so for like literally an hour or so more, they packed all of these fursuiters into one room, which I thought was just like stupid, but because like
it was honestly better than the line, because the line was just
The line was
just dissolved to a clump. The festival was honestly more organized than the line.
Yeah, the line, like, it just, everyone gets in this line, you have no idea what you're doing. It's like standing in a Star Tours line lining up for particular, like, oh, you're gonna go down this row and you're gonna go down this row. And then all the bystanders stand off to the side, and then, you know, we go in after the fursuiters, and they go in, and I don't really know what happened after you guys went in, so if you could better elaborate. I wasn't allowed in because I was not a fursuiter.
Yeah. They just huddles us up into a little corner, or not a corner, but just this kind of, this area marked off with tape, and they said, okay, everyone, just stay here. We stayed there for probably like 10, 20 minutes. Like, we're all, this is my first fur con, so I'm like, I don't know what's going on. Well, it ended up being the photo shoot, so here we are, just everyone just huddled up, really close, touching each other, and yeah, so we got our pictures, and the room was actually pretty big, so there is plenty of room to walk around. We could even go outside, but yeah, so once we walked around, they started saying, like, okay, the headless lounge in the back, if you want to leave, there's a door, there's just mats and games over there, and then I assume that's why we wouldn't start a lot of people in.
Yeah, the festival room itself was ginormous. I think it was just a little bit bigger than the dealer's den itself. I do have a video, I'll show it real quick, of how big the room is. And I kind of explained, there's these numbers that are posted against the wall, all the way around the festival. And there was like numbers 1 through 5 or 1 through 6. And there would be an announcer guy, and he'd say, okay, happening at photo booth 1, blah, blah, blah. Photo booth 2, all the foxes. Photo booth 3, all monochromatic in colors of gray, black, and white. And they were just really, like, kind of like shuffling fursuiters all the way around. And I kind of felt bad because my husband is, he's a gray fox, but his colors are like white, gray, brown, and black. And so he didn't know where to go, really, because, like, they didn't announce. I didn't hear that they announced for foxes. Apparently there was a fox photo shoot. But because there was, like, a shat ton of fursuiters, there's no way that all the fursuiters could just huddle into one particular photo set. So he ended up not getting his picture taken in the mini, like, photograph booths. He got a major picture taken, like, with all the fursuiters, but I kind of felt bad. Like, I feel like it should have been just a little bit more organized, but...
Well, what's his dominant color on his suit? It's gray, isn't it?
It's multiple dominant colors. It's white, a little... It's got brown... gray, and it's got black on there, so he falls under...
Well, I mean, what does it have the most of those colors?
I think it's gray, white, maybe. And
I would go towards one of those.
Well, he tried to go into the monochromatic one, mm-hmm. But there was just way too many suitors. I mean, like, they said monochromatic, and like, I swear to God, 3/4 of the con, like, a fursuiter just kind of like swarmed to that area, and I'm like, well, forget this. So
we'll find another one.
We'll find another booth. Yay. So there's just tons of stuff. I'm gonna pull up this video real quick.
Okay.
And show you guys. Oh, there's gay baby jail part 2.
You need to show that before I have to go.
I will. I'll show it in just a few seconds or just a minute or so. I'm just gonna pull up. Where's the dealer's den on here? I wrote it down as something. Oh, last day of the dealer's den. That would be the... Well, I guess that's the dealer's den, but I need the... What do I called it something. I'm so sorry. Give me a second here. Ah! Duh! It's called Fursuit Festival. Okay, so I gotta adjust it to the screen so everyone can see it. I do apologize if the noise is super loud, folks. Okay, sound.
It's really loud in here, but this is the festival whatnot. So it's just there's these numbers on each wall, and they all represent different photo booths. This room is just huge, just huge. Like, I just spin around here, kind of show you look at the beach. Felix is in this one. It just goes on. There's so many suits.
And so that's how it was. It was like super loud and you know, like all that noise going on. That last second where I said this is the group that Felix is in, you can see like how many like fursuiters of that color were in that area. So it's like impossible for anyone to get in there. now, before you go, Falky, I do have parts 1 and part 2 of Gay Baby Jail.
Oh my god.
I think these are my favorite. Because even towards the end of the con, I think this is probably my favorite part of these videos, because I was going through and I'm like, okay, I gotta show these videos because they're so freaking hilarious. So Falky is right here.
Right.
You've made it over.
Yes. I am now a gay baby gel.
Gay baby gel. Yes.
Gay baby snake.
I saw this and I was like, what?
I don't know, but you got attacked by that pink-haired suitor.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, so before massively this, like, attacked. She's on her way over and this other fursuiter got up and, like, no started attacking her. No, and I'm like, oh, no. She's not going to make it.
It's a gaby gel.
Okay, now it's, like, just now starting.
It's so hard to walk in this.
But it's she's so cute in this. She like pokes her head out here in a second.
Cute looking.
It was so hard to see in that box.
What's in this side? I'm gonna zoom in. There's nothing over there.
Boop.
I feel like I stick my head out. That would have been so much easier.
You should have just stuck your head out that way, man. And then walked.
I know, I didn't know I could. Oh my goodness.
So there's...
Oh, that is my boyfriend sitting in that couch with the cup and everything on him.
Yeah, I was talking to your boyfriend. He's a really cool guy. I was just talking to him while I was filming you, so you can like hear my side chatter or him chatting with me, and then he was chatting with Felix too, so... he was a really cool guy. It was nice meeting him. I think I might have... We might have zoomed in on the Gay Baby Jail Part 2.
I've got a hedgehog sitting next to me in her Gay Baby Jail.
Are you chilling on the couch in Gay Baby Jail?
I think we get a picture of it
all
somewhere.
Over there by the giant night light or light bright thingy, and now she goes all the way over here. It's so
I
cute.
I needed to sit on the couch, but I also couldn't leave my box.
Now you gotta keep your box. Your box is the most important.
Yeah.
It's a box life for you.
Now I need to figure out how to drive 4 hours home in a box.
Did you guys drive all the way from?
I did, yeah. He flew in from Alaska.
I think up there it says, like, gay baby chill.
So luckily I could meet him here, but.
Yeah, okay. I'm sign.
I think I do have pictures of it, though. So, not on here, but I'll be uploading pictures on Fur Affinity of all the 400 pictures that I've taken. But I only compiled so many together for this particular show. So, there is a lot that happened. There was a couple other things that happened. There was another video of, like, you being attacked. And I'm like, oh, it might be too long. Because that one was, like, a 2-3 minute long video. And I'm like, oh, I can't show the whole thing. But it was kind of funny because you are starting to walk over, and it was just like this waddle of like a box walking over, and all of a sudden this other fursuiter is like, hey, look, a box. And so they pick up this ball, and I'm like, I bet they're going to attack it. And they go, wham, and they throw the ball at the box, and I'm like, damn.
Destroy all boxes.
Yeah, and then she picks up like this. It looked like a 4x4. And she picks up like this big old like cardboard 4x4, and she starts just like hitting the box, and I'm like, oh my god, stop.
I just want to live. I just want to take the box. It was rightfully mine.
Yeah, it was funny. There was a lot of fun things that happened.
Like, I did hear the something, god, but sounds I had amazing. No idea what it was. Like, thump, thump. Like, oh, there's someone out there. Yes. Are they like slapping the box?
All these, you didn't hear him at all?
I could hear the thumping, but okay. I didn't know that they were actually like throwing stuff at the box. I thought they were just hitting it.
No, she like picks up this giant inflatable ball and she first throws that at the box. And then she picks up like this, it was cardboard, but it looked like a giant like wooden 4x4 kind of like a cardboard thing. And she starts like kind of like tapping the box, and then like she gives up, but then she comes back and like hits the other side. I'm like, dang, this girl's not giving up. So, this was not, however, the only box of madness here, because there was like another one. There was Super Punishment Time Box Man.
Yes, that was the real, like, he was a guy. He won BLFC. That's it, just hands down.
Yeah, like, there's this Asian guy, and we heard him after, like, while we were leaving the con. We heard him talk, and he was talking totally normal, so he had no accent whatsoever. So he does, like, this Asian accent, and he's like, oh, super punishment time! And you're like, he has this box that's a cube, and each side has a different, like, thing on it. So you can have, like, punishment time, super punishment time, and then he holds, like, these two white giant fans, and if you get punishment time, he hits you with them in the legs. So it's like, but here's the best part. Where one person might just do this for like a couple hours, he was there every single day doing the same thing. And he just kept doing it. I'm like, this guy has got to have an award because he's been doing it all this con. And it is fantastic. And I got videos of it too and pictures.
We need to just track him down and just give him like just big banquet and awards and everything. It's a big old formal thing. He was Super Punishment Guy at BLFC.
He was Super Punishment Guy.
I think you should play one of the videos.
Definitely.
You will. I will do it right now. How's our time on with you?
I think I'm okay.
Okay. I'll play this Super Punishment Time because this is pretty funny.
I
need to make the time to come out to BLFC next year.
But you will? You?
Yeah, I think I might try because
oh
my
god,
it's awesome.
It is great. Like, just everything that you could ever want in a convention, all the things you want to do, all the places you want to eat, this place has it because it is a resort. Because it's a resort, it has to have everything. So here's Punishment Guy. You'll see it right here. He's this Asian dude right here, and he's got this box. And so,
got out by your friend. No one likes a title town. Oh. Whoa! Wow! I too prize me now! You get pocket money and killing me! Good job, loser!
Go roll his dice!
You don't toss my dice? Go to the dice with a prize! Come prize me now! I'm out of cards, so instead you get funky prize!
Yeah! Look at that!
You have been betrayed by a friend! Again!
This guy had prizes, like, no joke. He had, like, the best prizes. He had Pocky, Like full size Pocky. So full size Pocky, he had one called Hi Chu Hit Chu. So he gives you a Hi Chu and then he hits you.
There was cards. I got a card from him. It had anime on the back. I think it was Soul Eater.
Yeah, yeah, there's a card. There was he made like a boatload of origamis. So he would give you an origami if he rolled it. There was Punishment Time, Super Punishment Time, and something else. So that was fun. I want to see if I picked up the other one because, let's see. There's the Sexiest Women. There's Basis Jesus. No, I don't think I have the other video, but it was funny. I'll have to upload them onto YouTube so everyone can see them because they're just so funny. We got to find this guy. It shouldn't be hard. All you got to do is Google, or I guess search on Fur Affinity now that it's up online, finally. that we can search Punishment Time and see if it pulls up anything. Well, of course, we'll have to put our like SFW blockers on because you know things are going to come up. They kept with the theme. Like there was a theme of like you're always being watched. So they had fake motion cameras, like kind of like Velcroed all over the walls. So as you walked by them, they would go and they'd like kind of like motion back and forth, which was really cool. That was a fun one. Let's see. I got what should we? What else is there? There's oh yeah, we had our panel. We had our how to fursuit dance or how to dance panel. That was fun. That was good because we actually
Did you teach everybody your slick moves?
No. I didn't do any of my slick moves. What ended up happening is like with any of our shows, nothing ever happens in order. So, we did like 30 minutes of like Ronnie and those guys kind of talking about dancing, and then the last like hour and a half, which we ended up taking up 2 hours because that's pretty much how much we needed. We ended up like it was really cool. They taught a dance move. Her and Taylor and Telephone kind of both came up with like a few seconds of a routine, and then the cool part was is for the rest of the song, they actually got the rest of the attendees to come up with ideas or routine ideas for the dance itself. And then Taylor would incorporate that into an actual routine. And then she would have everyone do it, like teach it. And then we would play it back on music and we'd all dance to it. So of course, like I wasn't really dancing that much because I was up on the stage kind of getting the music ready and regulating things. We had McNabb was there and McNabb is a really cool guy, but he was so nice to, what is he like? One, two, three, four, maybe four plus cameras were set up with microphones and stuff. So they were all linked perfectly. So that means that no matter what video shot he was taking, the sound will always sync up, which is great. So we got a ton of that too. And I got some videos of the panel routine itself. So let me pull up. This one.
Oh, nice. I'm glad that I missed this. This looks really cool.
Right. And just know how it looks when you move. It makes a big difference. Know what it looks like. Know what you will look like on stage. That way you can get an idea of if you think you have like just the greatest choreography down.
Sexiest women ever.
And you do it up on stage, it might not look the same. That happened with which one? My anthropology. I have had that happen. Or you
not. That is actually that was Telephone's new. Telephone had a new suit that she was wearing, and it looks so big and like bulky on her. But it's got like a lot of padding and stuff. That was cool.
I love the little tail nub. It's adorable.
Yeah, the tail nub is great. And then to kind of show you the routine that they had.
Look at that. Do it again. Oh, okay. Sorry.
So it was funny because I wasn't really running the panel itself at that point. It was like Taylor and Telephone were telling me what to do. And I'm like, hello, what? This is my panel. but, you know, I was actually okay with it because they're the ones who are the pros and they know how to dance. And so they were doing the dance for us. We learned this one really cool one. I think they call it the mogul. And it's, let's see, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different sets of dance moves, but they're the corny, cheesy ones that I learned. So they're really fun. and we all got to learn it. And then when we were actually out on the dance floor, I actually used the mogul. And I'm like, this is so cool. Where are they when I need them right now to, like, totally just, like, take over the dance floor? But they were golfing. So they I snorted. Shut up.
It just means you're really happy.
Never forget the day that space snorted.
Yeah.
Live on FurMedia.
I don't think I've ever really snorted on FurMedia before. I think it might be the first time.
It's a first.
Okay, so this this picture right here actually shows you the sparkles on my badge. So when I registered, I got a sparkly badge. And I asked them, I'm like, did anyone else get this? And they're like, not that we know of. So I'm assuming I'm the only one, unless anyone else got one, got a sparkle badge and a blue shirt. And I'm like, blue is my favorite color. I love to wear sparkles because I'm wearing it right now. How perfect is this? Someone must have tailored this particular package to me specifically, because there's just like no way this would have ever been like that. So everyone kept asking me, like, where'd you get your sparkles from? And I'm like, it's in the badge. I don't know. So it was actually, it was really cool. What's going on in?
I like that it looks like you have one black foot and one white foot.
Yeah, no, that. So yeah, that's those are my fursuit feet paws. I was I wanted to demonstrate what a fursuit feet paw looks like when it's furred, and then what it looks like when it's not furred. And you can kind of see all the different lines that I made. And I wore my feet paws twice at that con for everyone
to
see.
That's a fun idea. Did anybody stop you and ask, like, hey, what's up with that?
No. No. I think half of them were probably drunk.
Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of, I'm actually, like, riding the go-karts, and I went to go sit down after I got off. And I sit down at this picnic table, and there's a thing of Fanta and a thing of beer there.
What?
I wish I was kidding. And then, like, the first day of the con, I was also, I was waiting around. And I'm just over at this table, I see these business cards on it, so I'm looking at it. And I also noticed this beer bottle on it. I think there's two of them. And then there was also a Bad Dragon thing right next to it. So I was like, this is, like, you cannot not realize that this is a furry convention. Complete with alcohol and stuff, yeah, for the lewd.
There's a lot of alcohol at that convention. And then everyone was telling me, like, you can carry your alcohol downstairs on the floor. And I'm like, you can? And they're like, this is Vegas. This is Nevada. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I totally forgot about that. So I took a malt beer down to Fox & Moore and Pepper Coyote's show, and I drank it. And I felt great.
I forget that it's in Mini Sin City.
So, well, I think we've hit our lot of time with you. I'd love to keep you on more, and we'll probably have you on again.
I can stay on if you need me to. I mean,
well, we have two other guests as well. They're gonna come on because they also got their pictures with me. So that was like the rule. If you got a picture with me, you had a chance to become a guest. So,
all right.
Well, before you go, I'm going to plug your FA here into chat, and I think everybody should go and check out Falky's suit and artwork. It's very, very nice.
I'm a little bit more active on my Twitter. It's just that, so if anyone wants to also check that out.
And
plenty of BLFC pictures.
You guys probably, you should recognize Falky, because I've actually played with her art a few times. There's one where Paula Deen's riding a rocket, and it's like flaming Falky's face, and then Falky comes back and makes another photo, like, or a picture in response to that. So it's kind of fun that we've like played back and forth. But what the best part was is I didn't realize who you were until I turned around. I'm like, so it's
I remember once you realized it was me, that was
so that's the thing. So this is what I really got excited for, seeing my fans and seeing the people that follow FurMedia. I fangasmed over people like you. I don't necessarily had people fangasm over me as much. In fact, I only maybe had like two or three. I would be okay with that. But I want to meet everyone that I can possibly get in contact with. And that was fun for me, to see people like you and to see people like, I hope I don't say it wrong. Kibaki, I think is her name. or Kia. And then Matthew B was another cool person to meet in person. I'm like, oh my God, it's you. You're the one from chat. So it was really cool that, and I saw them several times here at the con, and they either hung with us or whatever. And it was just a lot of fun to be with the people that know who we are. That was exciting for me. So I'm glad I got
I
to meet you.
That happens.
Yeah, it was great to meet you too. And then also on the last day, catching you on the floor, kind of punched over onto the couch.
Yeah, we were tired. We were pretty tired.
Aww. I could tell.
Yeah.
Well, luckily it was the end of the con, so.
Yeah. Well, we appreciate you making some time to come on to our show, and we know you have to go to school.
I have to go be a good student.
Go be a good student, or you'll get super punishment time. So.
Honestly, I would miss class just for that.
I will send him in to your class. You are a teacher. You're making him teach. You're making him learn. Punishment time.
Please do it. I will pay you.
Oh, that would be so great.
Gay baby jail.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good old gay baby jail.
Never forget gay baby jail.
We'll never forget gay baby jail. All right, well, Falky, have a good night, and we'll have you on again another time, and enjoy your evening.
All right, cool. Thank you. Thanks for having me, though.
Oh,
cool.
Absolutely. No problem.
Yeah, good night.
Good night, guys.
Woo.
Boop, boop. Okay, so I was going to show something here.
I love her suit. It's so adorable.
It's so cute. So cute. Now, there were a couple of things I did want to show. Some other fun little doodads that happen. I attended Pepper Coyote and Fox & More's actual live shows, like their live concert. And it was fun because they were kind of like doing sound tests. And there was a part where Pepper's all like, something, something, my boobs, as he's singing. And I'm like, Felix is like, I bet he got that from you because you talk about boobs on your show all the time. So, because I've never heard him talk about boobs before. So I'm just like, yay. And they have this bassist that plays for them. And I swear to God, I'm not joking, folks. He looks like young Jesus. So I dubbed this video.
Jesus on bass.
I literally dubbed this video as Bassist Jesus, because that's the only way I would remember what it was. It was pretty funny.
Look at my super cool boobs.
So glad I got that filmed.
This is because I keep telling him he looks like a nurse in a hospital when he wears that horrible green shirt.
It's those green shirts.
How many do you have?
Maybe like 10. All the shirts I have are, I'm like a cartoon character. I'm like Shaggy. Only have green shirts.
Like, even there's Jesus! There's Jesus right there!
I was watching Scooby-Doo, and that song is
Fargon. Oh my God, he's so talented.
Scooby-Doo in WrestleMania, and John Cena was in it, because I got a poster for that. I'm like, that's a silly Photoshop, and it's a real movie. And it's not even that awful. Like, I'm like, this is going to be really bad. And it's like, eh. It does have Scooby-Doo having a fever dream and fucking... I already swore. I'm sick.
Aww.
Fever dream and friggin'.
Just one swear word for the show.
It's like he's fighting giant food. And the whole game revolves around like Xbox Kinect, like hypnotizing someone. They don't call it Xbox Kinect, but they're playing video games by doing this. So I'm like, you know.
I don't have an Xbox.
Concert reception up there.
I've always been a weeb.
Hey, we didn't give Wolf a mic. This is Wolf as our bassist. And he's just in the back. If you feel the need to talk, just run up, take a mic, yell into the overhead swing.
Isn't his hip, like, hair just amazing? He looks like a really young Saruman.
Or a Jesus. He looks like a Jesus. Bassist Jesus.
I didn't even say, like, bassist Jesus. And he said, like, something about, like, a really, really good-looking Sauron, I think, from, like, Lord of the Rings. So that was a funny reference.
That's awesome.
That was such a cool show, because, like, you hear Fox & More stuff, like, online, but to see him actually play, oh my God, that guy is so talented. He can sing and he can play. And not only can he play, like, there was at one point where he's just playing with his hands on one particular area of the keyboard, and on the other end of the keyboard, he was playing with his face. So I'm just like, how is that possible? how do you do that? And then, like, one time he was just, like, laughing so hard that he, like, sat down, but his hand was still up on the keyboard, and he was still playing really well. And I'm like, oh, my goodness. This guy is so talented. I want his stuff. Of course, I can't do that.
That is awesome.
That's terrible if I did that. but there's just one thing that we have to ask Pepper when we have him on our show again, as to why he takes his shoes off during concert. Have you noticed that? Has he done that before?
I haven't really noticed. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe he's just more comfortable playing that way.
Yeah, well, he takes his shoes off and then he puts them like in a nice little organized manner on the stage, and then Fox and Moore kind of like follows suit. He's like, okay, I guess we're taking our shoes off. So he takes his shoes off.
Everybody in the audience takes their shoes off.
And then, you know, of course, we need like Febreze. So I'm so glad no one else took the shoes off. Before we get to our next two guests, because I'm actually going to bring them on simultaneously, because that way it'll be a little bit easier, because then we can kind of talk about the second part of the convention and then go into Q&A, which will be kind of fun. What were you going to say something?
Oh, no. No.
Oh,
no.
I thought I had this. I know how much you hate that voice. It's not that bad.
Slap the anime girl right out of you.
So, okay. So, folks, I have discovered something that's more annoying than the 6-2-1 rule. So the 6-2-1 rule at conventions is 6 hours of sleep, at least 2 meals a day, and 1 shower. Okay? You could do all of those things if you want to. Great. Your fursuit smells fantastic. But there was one new thing that I have picked up, and I feel like the letter M needs to be added to the 6-2-1. So 6-2-1 M, and the M stands for mouthwash or mints. because every fursuiter that I came in contact with had really bad breath, and I'm just like, oh, you know, I love looking at your face. Your fursuit's so cute, but oh my god, your breath is terrible. And they were every fursuit except for Falky. Falky had good breath. Except for everyone else that I came in contact with, terrible breath, and I'm just like, gross. So it's not, has nothing to do with showers. It has everything to do with not brushing your teeth. So I think the M or the B needs to be added.
When I'm suiting, I make a point to choose some kind of mint flavored gum for two reasons. One, because it opens up like your nasal passages, like Vicks, so you can breathe better, and it keeps my mouth from drying out.
Yes.
So I don't get all too overheated in my fursuit head.
Yes. Okay. So without going into more delay, I'm going to bring on our next two guests, which is Kaya and Matthew B. These two Woo-hoo! Also showed up. So this is three people that I was familiar with at the convention floor itself. I don't really know if anyone else knew who I was. There was a couple Utah first, which I was so surprised by. Just because we watch yours. Like, I was walking down to our room, and they're like, is that Space? And I walk into my room, and I'm like, by the way, this is Space. And they're like, oh, I watch your show. And I'm like, cool. And I walk into the room, I'm like, who watches my show in Utah? Because I live in Utah. There's another show that dominates Utah, not our show. We dominate everywhere else. So I was just like, oh. So let me bring on Matthew B. I hope you're still online. Hello. I'm going to message him, and then I'll get Kaya on here in just a second. I'm going to add her to the group call. Actually, I can just do it from here and all that stuff. And oh my god. Can I, how do I boot?
Sound like a very blasé sheep.
Oh yeah, I can just add people to this call. Remember, I've always had issues with this, folks. Remember, just...
It's okay.
We've only done this We've only done this like a dozen times, and I still haven't figured it out. So, Okay. There we go. Add people
usually
to this
turns
call.
Out fine.
All show. Okay. Dun 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 dun. Okay, here's.
It's not Kaya. It's Kia.
Kia. Sorry, like
IKEA.
I got this. Switch your mode to online. Well, I'm calling them, but I don't know if they're picking up. Hello? Hello? We've called them. Hello? You guys, I'm going to start breaking out into song. Not dance, because you can't see me. All right, well,
you
I guess...
You did that at the con.
That's true. I already broke out into dance on the con floor. Well, maybe they're having some issues on their end. Try to figure out what your issues are.
We can try them again in a bit.
Okay, we'll try you again in a bit. For the meantime, while we refresh here, I'm going to show you some video at the After Dark Pepper Coyote and Foxamore panel that I went to. Yay. It is freaking hilarious. Yeah, it is good. You've been to this one. But this one, they were drinking more.
Were they sharing with everyone too afterwards?
The rule was is if you donate or you buy their album, you get to pour yourself as much as you can drink. Yep. And so they had this big old flask. In fact, I even got I bought one of his albums, and I was at the dealer's end. He had a big old swig of whiskey there, and he's mm-hmm. like, "Take a drink. What is that? Cringe. What is that noise? What is that?
Me.
Who is me?
Kia.
Hi.
Hi.
There we go. Okay. Freaked me out for a second there.
FurMedia ghost. FurMedia ghost.
Ah!
I can be a ghost.
Okay. Ooh, so I'm trying ghost. To. I don't know. I'm trying to answer the question here from Griffonius. I don't know what kind of whiskey it was, but it was It was just this big old tall bottle of whiskey. So I bought it. He's like, "Take a drink." And I'm like, "Okay." So I take a drink and I'm like, it was straight up whiskey. It wasn't flavored or anything. It was just straight up. And I felt like I took a gulp of Satan's gasoline. And it burned my throat. And I was just like, "This is gross. How can anyone like this? Ew."
That sounds like a pretty good whiskey.
I took a big swig.
So. That's also going to be our question for the night. Would you fuel up at Satan's gasoline?
No. 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 It was so potent. But at this particular, he's online, so we'll add him here. Matthew, we'll add you here in just a second. Okay, he's calling in, so I guess we're adding him to the call now. Oh, shit. Hold on. Hold on, I'm calling everyone back. Resume the call. Are you guys still there?
I'm still here.
Okay, good.
Put me on hold.
Sorry.
I was like, oh, no.
I have used my three swear words for the show. I've gone over the swear limit. Okay, I'm adding one more person to this call. So let's hope they pick up here. Bloop, they bloop, went bloop, online, bloop, so. Hello?
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 Hello? Yes.
FurMedia?
Yes, got
yes.
you.
I'm here. Woot.
Okay, okay. Okay. Okay, we're all here. Okay.
Fabulous.
Okay, right. So I'm going to show a video here. Nice burp. And so it's basically at the After Dark Pepper Coyote show. And the three annoying fruit from the annoying orange channel.
Have you good lord.
So it's not the people from the channel and stuff, but they've got costumes from it. And all of a sudden, Pepper just loses it, and you turn around. There's these three really sexy looking fruit back there. And it's oh my god,
spandex.
Their faces were horrifying.
Yeah, they were. So I dubbed this video Terrifying Fruit.
Apparently so.
First, I was afraid. I was petrified.
I only saw pictures of them, but just.
Sorry for myself. I am screwed.
And then they come up the row, which is even scarier.
So creepy.
So then they come. They're coming down the aisle, which is even creepier.
Oh no! On his knees too. Oh. That face. Well, I'm just gonna sit over here. Don't mind me.
So it was like that's basically what it was. It was those those three fruit.
Oh my god!
It was great. I don't know why, but it was so great.
You know, I tried my very best to try to repress that memory. Now you've just brought it up to the surface again. Thank you so much, Space.
You're welcome. So, how was the con experience for both of you two?
Well, considering it was my second convention, it was amazing.
Second convention for BLFC or second convention in general?
In general. My first one was FC, and that was like my very first. This was my second and first time being at BLFC, and oh my god, I didn't think so much stuff could happen at one place.
Yeah, well, you thought wrong.
Well, my friends told me about it, and I was like, okay, that sounds kind of interesting. And then I was like, well, I'm curious. Let's look at the website. And then page after page after page, I was like, holy sh... I gotta go.
I gotta go!
So it's safe to say that you weren't disappointed.
No, I was not disappointed. I was actually quite happy because my friends pre-regged, and they're like, you should do it. I'm like, I don't know if I can go... So I was kind of like dabbling on with my manager, like, can I? Maybe. Can I? No. Can I? Yes. Yes? Well, maybe. What do you mean, maybe? So I never actually got to pre-reg, but I got there, and I was literally like the first one to reg at con. There was like a line, and we kind of like snuck in, and we were the first people there. So I was literally in, I registered, I was in and out in like 2 minutes, and then my friends who were registering, they waited for like an hour. So I was like, ha! I got in before you. Irony, yes.
I've never had bad con experience yet. This is my fifth con, was BLFC.
Okay, and list your first four then, before this.
All right, my first convention was RMFC, because I live in Colorado. That was super close. That was a good place to start.
Woo.
Second one was MFF. I saw Punya there. I went by her table. I don't think she recognized me, though. Third one was Fursuiters in Milwaukee. That was awesome. Pepper was at that one too. That was really cool. And other than that, it was FWA, Furry Week in Atlanta. They were all great.
Which MFF did you go to? Did you go to Chlorine Con or the one after that?
No, my first convention was RMFC 2015. I've just been going to them as often as I possibly can.
Okay. Dang!
They've all been in the last few months.
You've missed out on the pool con.
I know.
Still my favorite.
I'm not sure if I'm glad that I missed that, because I didn't want to get gassed, thank you, but...
Well, it was funny because someone was like, I feel bad because I sent you to that con! And I was like, don't feel bad, it was like one of the best conventions I've ever been to. So it was actually quite good.
Despite the fact it happened, it was a really great con that year.
Yeah. So what panels did both of you guys attend?
Well, the etiquette one that you and I attended, that was much of a disappointment.
Oh my god. Tell everyone about this etiquette panel that we went to.
Okay, so it was basically an etiquette panel, like an online etiquette or whatever, and what I was anticipating was pretty much a good one, but I got there a little early, and all I see is like five people standing outside the door, and they're just talking, well, I'm kind of sitting and waiting. I didn't want to be late, but I didn't want to be like super early, but I guess I was kind of early anyway. And all I'm hearing is these people talking about what they're going to talk about. And pretty much all I heard was, yeah, we got this done in the matter of the last 30 minutes. 30 minutes. Yeah, yeah, it's going to be good. What are we going to talk about? I don't know, but we're going to make it work. So I was like, really? 30 minutes? And all I'm hearing from them, not to be like creeper, but I was the only one there in the hallway. They were just kind of sitting there saying, like, you know, they were going to prepare and just kind of wing it. And I was like, you can't just wing it. You can't. Oh my gosh.
They're not experienced like we are. They can't just wing it. We can wing it.
You do it fabulously.
I know.
So finally, Space shows up, and I'm like, Space! I'm spazzing out over here. And I was like, Space, I don't know. This is not going to be good, Space. I don't know if we can do this. Let's give it a chance. Okay. So we go, sit down. They have three topics, and they get to the second topic within the first 2 minutes. And I'm like, wait, what?
How? And I'm like, on my side, I'm like writing, I've got my binder open, like I've got this full on really cool looking pamphlet thing, and I'm like writing notes in here on the side. I'm like, this panel sucks. I'm writing side notes. I should take a picture of it and show it to people.
I was like, oh my god, what was it, the guac bowls?
Yeah, they were giving away guac bowls. Like, why?
I kind of wanted to get a guac bowl just to say I attended a stupid panel, but at the same time I was like, what am I going to do with a guac bowl?
Well, and the thing was, it's like, he's like, here, have a guac bowl. This is how I get people.
What's a guac bowl? Does anybody, what were the other little thing, the little harmonica looking things?
The kazoos.
The kazoos, yeah. He was like, anybody want a kazoo? We only got like six. They're like, whatever. I was like, I'm not touching a kazoo, but they were prepackaged, so I guess, but they were gone in like 30 seconds flat.
This is what this guy was giving out for his panel to get people into his panel. I'm like, worst panel giveaways ever. Like, who buys guac bowls?
It was like, Space.
That's a bad sign when you have to give people stuff to get them to come to your panel.
Usually we raffle off things at our panel. These are things that people have given to us. Or they're like really good, actually good prizes. But we give people ahead of time notice that this is going to happen. This guy just like pulled them out of a Walmart bag. He's like, yeah, I got these at Walmart. Have a guac bowl. And I'm like, I want to like punch you in the face right now. Because you're just
seriously,
being so
at least
stupid.
Get candy or get something that's kind of something. But
we
no,
love
guac
candy.
Bowls. What the fuck? Sorry, my language. What the hell?
That's, guac bowls. That's your swear word for the night.
Okay, I got it.
You had three, Space. We all get three now. It's only fair.
Yeah, that's fair.
Oh, I got two more.
You're going to have to raise the rating on this video, too.
I'm like a magic genie. You get three.
But here's...
You use one.
This is what killed me. They were saying you're not popular unless you have 1,000 followers.
But that
pretty much makes the statement that says you don't matter in the fandom if you don't at least have 1,000. And right there, and I'm just like, nope, I'm done. I can't do this anymore. This is messed up. So, like, probably a few minutes later after that, I'm just like, do you guys want to go? Let's go. We just got up and like left. We were done with this panel. It was such a waste of our time.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. Anyone who says that you're not worth it unless you have 1,000 people, they should just, you know, go away. Shoo. Go hide it. Well, they were like saying like, well, how many? I was like kind of sitting back here and I'm like, we have like 2,000 followers. But like, I didn't want to say anything because I'm like, it doesn't matter. Should it matter? It shouldn't matter. But it was so loud. People were swearing in that like panel and they were just
bragging about like, oh, hey, I shut down a con. Good for you.
Yeah, they were like being obnoxious. I'm like, I am done with this. Blech. So we left. And I don't know what we did. We went somewhere else after that. We hung out with Kia for a while. And then we dropped off and we went somewhere else. We went back up to our room. We met Matthew, but I don't remember where I met you. Where did I find you? Where did you find me?
I think we found each other at the Foxes and Peppers show, at the main stage, not the After Dark one.
We found each other. It's like a love story.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Oh, it was that closing ceremonies, though. Do you remember Telephone got on that box, and we said that we needed to get her that foam sword so she could make her war speech.
Yeah, that's right.
That would have been perfect, but nobody brought a sword. So
no, that was too bad. Because we were kind of talking. Was it reference to like the telephone like Power Ranger thingy?
Right, exactly.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
What was that, last show or the show before that?
That was the artwork for that. I think that was last show. That was the last show we were talking about that, because it was so funny, and it would have been perfect if she had that like sword. Oh, that was beautiful. I do have pictures or videos of telephone. Let me see. Let me pull up this one here.
We should have totally bring it.
I only saw telephone once.
Oh, yeah. So this is...
Aside from the panel.
You could actually hear Matthew and I talking about it. Like, we were just like, he's where's the foam sword?
We should have totally bring it. Yeah, this can't end well for anyone.
I think she pushes her off, too. Like, bam!
Headbutt. Shove.
I want it to be Christmas time again.
I'm gonna try this again, but not close to you.
Yeah.
Foam swords, yes, but they also need those giant, what is it?
Yeah.
The little ear things, and you just bop each other. Yeah.
Maybe we shouldn't give Telephone a sword. I think she might be a bit dangerous.
Tears on the defense. My tear!
Yeah, so they play like jump rope with their tail. So that was a lot of... Oh, there's pictures right there. And this... I don't know if anyone got one of these, but did anyone get the PCD emergency kit?
Oh, I wanted one of those, but I didn't get any.
That sounds like a great thing to have.
I didn't get one at this convention, but I got one at MFF. It was bubble wrap, right?
Yeah, that's what it was. It was bubble wrap.
That was awesome. Best idea ever.
It was like this cheetah. I don't remember what his name was. He's always at BLFC, and he's a dancer. So if anyone knows who I'm talking about, please message me and let me know so I can correct myself. But he had this box, and it says PCD, or Post-Con Depression Kit. And it's like an emergency kit, and it says only open in case of emergency. And I'm like, it's an emergency right now. I got to know what's inside. I open it up, and I'm like, bubble wrap! Yay! It was so amazing. Cool. We saw a lot of fursuits there. I saw the lion. The lion... from Zootopia.
Oh, Lionheart?
Oh, the mayor?
Yeah, the mayor.
The mayor one that... Lionheart?
Yeah, that guy was a douchebag. I'm just gonna... He was. I'm sorry, but he was. Like, he's walking around at the Fursuit Festival, and I know he clearly saw my husband. He hit my husband. I don't know if Felix realized it, but he, like, totally nudged him, and I'm like, what the hell? You Jew? You douche? Not a... I didn't say Jew. I said douche. I meant to say douche. So I'm just like, that guy's a douche. Whatever. I'm not. If I get him on this show, which I have right now, I'm going to call him out and say, you're a douche jerk. You're a douche jerk. I can't speak right now. Oh!
Bad.
Oh! So. Yeah, so there was that. What was the other?
I was just happy to see Scar from Lion King. That guy, saw him wandering around. I was like, there's a Scar? Someone made a Scar?
I didn't see Scar.
I saw Scar, and I saw him surrounded by, like, a bunch of random people who had, like, random Lion King shirts. And I was like, oh my god!
let me go into the boob tube. No, sorry, the Facebook. I call it boob tube for some reason, because my other friend calls YouTube boob tube, and I don't know why. But I'm going to go on to my... Oh, crap. I don't remember what my password is. Just kidding.
JK.
Just kidding. I'll just pull up... There we go. This works. Let's just pull up our own thing. I uploaded a shat ton of... No, I'm not going to log in. Pictures onto YouTube itself. So, or not YouTube. Why do I keep saying YouTube? Dang it!
Facebook.
Facebook.
Fasabuka.
The Fatal Book.
While I'm doing this, why don't you guys tell me your favorite moments of the convention? What you liked most and what you didn't like most?
Oh gosh, that's hard to put.
Dun dun dun. Sucks for you.
My favorites to say, let me see. A lot happened. I was just kind of like running around. The people that I went with, they were like mostly kind of went out, did their own thing, and then went back to the room. They were kind of stuck in the room. I was like, I'm gonna go, guys. I'm gonna enjoy this con. See ya. So I was kind of like out of the room for a long time, and they're like, you know what? Here, have your own key. Just don't make noise when you come back to the room. Okay. I think the most fun I had was probably when me, Space, your husband, and what was the other guy? One of your friends. We all went down to the arcade, and we were just like totally having so much fun on that one game, the Pac-Man game.
Oh yeah, Kurigari. Kurigari went with us. Yeah.
Yeah, we're just having fun. Me and your husband were just like, yes, win one, lose one, yes. But that was like the most fun I had, and I was like, oh my god, that. And I think the next best moment I had was probably having coffee with you, and then what's it called, the director of the furries.
yeah
so I that was like the highlight of my entire like con, and it was only like the first official day of con, and I was like, oh my god, I got to meet them both. That was the whole reason why I wanted to come to this convention, and I met them both, and I'm having coffee. Granted, I was blind. I didn't have my glasses with me. I literally rolled out of bed and I was like, you know what? I want coffee. Everyone's sleeping. Forget this. I'm going downstairs. And then I just get a random message from Space. He's like, are you at coffee? Are you at Starbucks? I'm like, maybe. We're right behind you.
I'm being like a super creeper too.
I'm looking around. I'm looking where? And he's like, we're right behind you. I'm like, I can't see. I'm blind. I don't have my glasses on. Turn around, walk straight. Okay.
Suddenly, so. Polar bear comes into view.
Yeah.
Giant Steven Universe shirt. And I was like, ah, should've known.
It's not hard to miss.
I'll tell you what I didn't enjoy about the convention is that Kage didn't show up for his story hour. That was a bummer. He missed his flight, apparently.
What?
I heard he was attacked at his hotel or something.
I don't know, but all I know is that the poker tournament was at the same time as the story hour. So I busted out of the poker tournament almost intentionally so I could go see Kage, and he didn't show up, and I went back to the poker tournament and said, can I have my chips back? And they said, no.
Oh no!
So, oh well. That's alright.
Ninjas.
Yeah, I don't know, but the thing was, is he was only flying in for that one panel too, though.
Right.
I'm like, who flies in just for one panel? That's kind of lame.
I was gonna go attend his panel, but then something happened. I think my friends, they wanted to go like go kart racing or something like that, and I was like, okay, because I'm the only logical person to actually take pictures. We left that to one of my friends last at FC, and she somehow wiped out my camera, and that had 200 pictures. And I was like, what did you do? She's like, I don't know. You're not supposed to leave me with pictures. And then when she did take pictures, they were all blurry. And I was like, okay, I'll take the pictures.
That's always such a bummer.
Yeah, I lost 200 pictures. I was like, this is from my first convention. Why would you do this to me? She's like, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm not good with technical stuff.
I kind of wish I discovered this. It's a giant light bright panel. They like made a giant light bright panel. And it was, I didn't know that it was in the main hall. So I went in there and I'm like, there's a giant light bright panel and I can play with it. Yes. So I took apart someone's, other thing, and I wrote poop on it. That's the first thing that came to mind. I don't know. So you got Trump, and then it says poop, and that's it. So I saw that, and I'm like, oh, I gotta play with it.
I saw it. I wanted to go play with it, but then I just felt bad. I didn't want to move anybody else's stuff. And I was like, why can't they just make like a million of these and just put a whole wall of them?
Now, like you mentioned, yeah, you mentioned. Matt, did you go to the Furries documentary panel?
I caught the end of it, not the whole thing.
But okay, but at least you got some of it.
Some of it.
Okay. So if, for those who don't know, and most of you should know, because we've been following this since, I guess it's actual, yeah, since the beginning. And we finally, Punya and I got to see a sneak peek of the film being like made, MFF 2014. Good. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And we both cried.
We did.
No shame. And then we got to, I went and watched this one. It was an extended version, so I got to see more of it. And it was really just like, I kind of did cry. I cried a little bit because it was just,
you relate really closely.
Everyone,
it's like, what you really want to say about the fandom, and just, you don't have the words, and then you watch the film and you're like, yes, yes, that's it.
Yeah, it's it's everyone's awkwardness and everything that you wish you had earlier before you found the fandom, and then you find it and you're like, this is exactly how I feel, and you relate to the movie and it just makes a connection. So it's like, from the time that it started playing, from the time that it ended, I could have watched that thing 100 times. I would have never gotten bored because I felt so at home at that moment. And then what the best part was is one of the people that was in the film was actually there. So we got to meet them, and I went up to her and I'm like, I got to have you on our show. That's just not it's not a no, you will be on our show. So I was like really excited. So it was a good panel. It's probably one of the best. Besides mine, because mine was the best, but you know, then his was good too. I don't think there was any scares. I'm showing some pictures here from the Fursuit Festival. That was a lot of fun going in there and seeing all of these fursuiters. There were so many caribou and deer, and then I know that
I want to hug them all.
what their face is gonna love, a Rebel Savant, if they're still in chat. They're going to love the fact that I ran into so many angel dragons. So
they were Beast Cup makes pretty good angel dragons.
What was cool about these angel dragons is that their tails were really like rounded at the end.
They were thick, studded out. They stick out and nice. They don't just like hang limp. They actually like hang out from the body.
Yeah.
I love that.
It was beautiful. there were lots of red pandas there. Here's a shot of four red pandas.
Look at that.
The red pandas that are actually green.
Yeah.
The green pandas.
And then we actually met another red panda, but he was cotton candy cotton candy scented. Like his whole fursuit smelled like cotton candy. If you guessed his name, he gave you cotton candy. So both Felix and I got 2 packs of cotton candy, which was rad.
Yes.
And then they even had free cotton candy that you could have at the convention itself. So I'm just like,
oh, I had so much free cotton candy.
Hey!
Every time I walked by, I was like, $1 for you, more cotton candy. I know it's tips appreciated, but I'm just going to give you $1 anyway.
Yeah. There's a lot of cute fursuiters. I don't know who this fursuiter on the right is, but he's blue and he has eyes. And then there's the panda right there and he's cute. And
That panda has really pretty eyes.
I found a bear, and I had to get a picture with the bear.
The bear!
It was so cute.
Aww.
Okay, Punya, you're going to love this. You know how you love your Peets, right?
Mm-hmm.
This fursuiter's Peets were ginormous. So big that I took a picture.
Got pillow Peets.
He's got... They got pillow Peets.
Dust big Peets.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Dust big Peets. Amazing.
And I ran into this sexy, I don't know what this is, but it was a sexy suitor.
Ooh.
And I told him, hey, can you pose for me?
These are all really
nice
suits.
And they posed, and that was great.
That's awesome.
So, at this moment, do you guys have anything else you want to add to the convention before we go into Q&A?
No.
Nothing that I can think of, no.
Nope.
Just awesome overall. Yes, well done, BLFC.
Well, and I hope I'm going to be there again this next year. Like, we have to go next year.
Definitely. I will beg my managers again. Please, please, for the love of goodness, let me go.
So the questions have to be in that format as you see it in chat. Wow, someone's already got their question locked and loaded. Hello. That's funny. And so we'll answer those questions also for the people that went to BLFC that are in the chat, and then people that we have here. So we got Matthew, and we also have Kia, and then we got myself. If you have questions for us about BLFC, feel free to give us an ask. And of course, if you guys, Matt and Kia, if you have questions you want to ask Punya and I in general, feel free to go ahead and just jump in and ask a question if you'd like to. And we'll do this for a few minutes or so.
Key beans.
The first question, though, from Dominic Raccoon. This goes for everyone on Skype. If you had a chance to make out with any celebrity and then erase their memory, who would it be?
I don't know.
That's a tough one. That's a real tough one.
A young Leonardo DiCaprio.
Wow.
He was, like, my soulmate when I first watched Titanic. I was like, oh. And then, like, every other movie he's ever been in, I've really liked his roles, and he plays his roles really well, so I think it had to be him. If not him, I don't know, there was this one guy named Josh Holloway, I think. I don't remember what he played, but he's pretty handsome.
He's pretty.
Yes. Pretty handsome.
I need to think about it for a second. I'll come back to me.
Nothing. Just say.
Yeah, you gotta say it.
I don't know. Jennifer Connelly.
That was my pick.
No, it wasn't.
It wasn't. it wasn't.
I think younger Jennifer Connelly is just adorable.
Ewan McGregor for me.
Ooh.
Hello. Those blue eyes, man. Doesn't he have blue eyes? Well, he does in Star Wars.
That's all you need to know.
Yeah.
At some point, as long as he's got them.
That's not really something I've ever thought about. Jennifer Lawrence.
Ooh! Nice! What's her name in what do they call her? The Mockingjay. You want to make out with the Mockingjay?
Yes. Sexy Mockingjay.
Sexy Mockingjay. Okay. This next question is so easy to answer. From Eisen, the best and worst panel you went to at BLFC.
The worst, the etiquette. The best, for media. Duh.
The worst would be the etiquette, and the best for me would probably be the After Dark Pepper Coyote panel.
I fell asleep. Oh. I didn't get to go. I wanted to. I was just not feeling good, and I was like, okay, I'm just going to take a short nap, and then I'll go. And when I woke up, I was like, ah, it ended like 2 hours ago. Never mind.
It happens.
For me, the Foxes and Peppers After Dark, that would definitely be my favorite, too. And jeez, for the worst one.
I guess technically for you, it could be the Kage.
Yeah, I'm going to go with that.
Because he didn't show.
Yeah, that's the worst panel that I did not go to.
I didn't go.
And you didn't go, so you can't answer. Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun.
I had to show this picture. There's this picture over here of this guy who's wearing a cardboard box, not a cardboard cock. That's not what I was trying to say there. I do apologize.
But it
was literally, that's what they called it, the $10 fursuit head. And he got all these people to sign his fursuit head. So I actually had to go there, and I wrote my name on there too. I gotta say, it's actually kind of genius. I liked it. Not many people did, but I kind of liked it. I thought it was funny.
I love it that, you know, he didn't just go for a day and then just like, you know, I'm going to call it quits. No, he went everywhere with that. I was like, yeah. That's dedication right there. I love it. Yeah,
and he had like permanent markers in his pocket, and he's like, here, sign my head. And I'm like, that's awesome. Save that. Don't ever get rid of it.
That's great.
Awesome.
Question from Griffonius. You mentioned doing another art review in June. Can we get a tentative date? I want to know when I need to start making another sculpture. Oh. Let me look at the map here. Let's see what's in the 30th would be the next show. The 6th, probably the 20th. I'd say the 20th might be a good date.
That'll work.
Yeah. It's usually Monday, so the 20th of June might be a good time. From Citrine Husky, what con are you each attending next?
I am going to be at AC.
Air conditioning con?
That's right.
That sounds amazing.
Best con there is.
I too am going to air conditioning. It will be very cool there.
Oh.
So come and be cool with us.
Yes.
What about you, Kia?
Currently, I don't think I'm going to anything at the moment. Just got back and a lot of stuff has happened at work and they're like, you shouldn't have left to begin with. I'm like, but you gave me the okay. Yes, but now stuff is changing, so I don't know if I'll be able to go to anything else this year. Hopefully, but probably not till the end of the year, see if anything comes up. If not, I wait till next year where I'll probably go to FC and BLFC again.
I think for me, I don't have anything else that we have in the funds to attend. But I'll see when the next anime con. There's a lot of comic cons here in Utah. Like, I guess we're now like the number one comic con in the U.S., which is pretty awesome. But there is an anime bonsai that I might want to go to, kind of just explore the anime fandom a little bit. And I guess there's a Brony con too, and I'm not a big fan of the bronies, but you know, you gotta attend at least one of those to kind of get an idea. So I might do that.
Think about it, I probably might go to AX in July. It's kind of been a thing,
so that sounds like a good idea. From Loop, what happened to your mirror?
I was gonna ask about that too.
Punya, unplug and unplug again. Or plug in blah, 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 blah. Hold on, because you sounded really crazy. You sounded like...
There
you go.
Terminator.
A
female Terminator. Blah, 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 blah.
Where's John?
All right, so... I don't know where the pictures are for that particular mirror. Let me go see if I can find it on Twitter real quick. So on my way to BLFC, I don't want to go there because there might be some links you shouldn't see. Not to say that there are in general.
Plausible deniability space.
Yeah. Let me go find this picture real quick because it's pretty funny. It's funny what happened. It's not... Okay, I got the picture. All right, so what you see before you in this picture right here is a duct-taped mirror on the driver's side. What happened was we were on our way from Utah to Nevada, and there's a lot of construction in Nevada. And there was this one part where they were merging the left lane into the right lane, and there were two giant semis in front of us, and they've already lowered the speed limit from 80 to 55. So that's like a dramatic... amount of speed you can't go. And to go stuck behind a truck because they can't go up hills, it's going slower. And I'm like, oh, F this. I'm not going to get stuck behind these things. I think I can do it. So I clear the first truck. And then there's at least a semi-space of a truck in between the next one. And so I keep going. And my friend Rue is like, what are you doing? And I'm like, I'm going to make it. He's like, space, you're going to hit the truck. I'm like, I'm not going to hit the truck. Dang it. And as we're like both screaming like, you know, sorority girls.
No, you don't.
Yeah. We're both screaming in this car. I wish we had a remote, like a microphone in here because it was hilarious. The truck is getting closer to the right side of my car and the cones are getting closer to the left side of my car. I don't want to hit the truck because I don't want to die. And all of a sudden, I just kind of totally freak out. And so I get closer to the cones and I hit one of the construction barrels with my left side of the mirror. And it's fine. And I'm like, it's fine, it's fine. And all of a sudden, boom. And like the other, like it totally hits the mirror. And I'm just like, Ah! My mirror! And then I pull over to the left side of the road completely, and then I hit the other mirror with another construction barrel, and I'm like, roll down the window, just push it back, it'll be fine. And like, we just keep going. We get in front of the trucks and we just keep going. And I was telling him, like, oh my god, they're gonna go, there's CB radios, they're gonna say there's this red car on the road, I'm gonna get a ticket, I'm gonna get arrested, blah, 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 blah. And I just started freaking out, and like, Rue's like, calm down, your defensive driving saved us. And I'm like, but look at my driver's side window, it's just dangling there. So what you don't see here is, like, this mirror is, like, literally hanging off to the side in the wind because it's being held on by defroster wires. And so I put it back into the, like, into this holding, and it kind of locks back into place. And right as we get up and around the mountain, it, like, pops out. I'm like, it's not staying. We pull over to a rest stop, and surprisingly enough, Felix and Kurigari, like, in the other, because we were all in a caravan, they were super calm about it. And, like, I look over to Rude, I'm like, your boyfriend's gonna kill me because I almost killed you. And he was surprisingly okay with it. So now, like, there's this joke. Like, every time we get into the car, it's like, don't hit a construction cone. So
Don't
hit two of them. So now I'm actually literally afraid to drive next to semis. And so now on the freeway, I refuse to pass them. If I'm going to pass them, I'll be at least two lanes away from them before I even do it, because I'm terrified of them to begin with, but now I'm just like super scared to drive next to them.
You can pass them, just do it within a reasonable amount of time. Especially if, well, you're gonna be merging over.
Jeez. Let's just say Space did not judge the space correctly in front of him.
Space had a hard lesson about depth perception.
Yeah. Oh my. It sucked. That was the scariest ever. Let's see. From Disney Mudkip, do you watch any... Wow, this is a broken up question. Do you watch
any YouTubers? Do you watch any YouTubers who aren't furries?
Oh, yes. I watch Good Mythical Morning, BuzzFeed, I watch Game Grumps and a bunch of those guys.
Yeah, definitely Game Grumps for me, or Markiplier. Markiplier's life. aside from that, not much.
I'm trying to think. I don't watch YouTubers so much as I used to, but before that I used to watch... I started out really watching Shaytards every day, and also Game Grumps. I watch more JonTron now. Oh gosh, I can't remember the name of that one guy. The guy who's always like, I do not look like a raccoon. Equals three guy. What's his name?
Oh, Equals three. Oh, yeah. Ray William Johnson.
Yes. I watch his stuff a lot.
I'm looking through my subscription list on YouTube. Most of these people are furries. CinemaSins, How It Should Have Ended, Tom Ska, Element Animation, some of these. Yeah. I don't know. not a lot of them, but yeah.
I do a lot of game theories.
Yeah, those are good. I like watching How It's Made videos. I could watch a total binge watch of How It's Made. And I also like to watch a lot of World War II and World War I, like, documentaries on YouTube. Strongly with the atomic bombing. I know that sounds weird, but sometimes I get into a mood where I'm just like, I just want to watch it. So
follow, click, what's this? And then binge on that for, like, 3 hours.
Yeah, pretty much. It's pretty much how it goes.
Yeah, that's me with... like documentaries on animals and stuff. I'm like, ooh, random migrations. Let's learn about migrations. Yay.
Yeah. And then you get onto some like random YouTube poop and you're just like, what am I watching?
Exactly. That's where you find the best ones. You're like, I didn't know this existed, but now that I do, let's just try to remove that from brain.
I watch a lot of like National Geographic and Discovery channels on there. Smithsonian, things like that. So like any chance that I can get to watch some kind of video with critters in it, I'm happy.
It's always good. The next question from Aizen. What was the best fursuit hug at BLFC? I got a lot of hugs, so I can't really say which one.
I've got an answer for that. Yes. Like you said, at the Foxes and Peppers After Dark panel, they had that booze up at the front. Being as how I am absolutely, totally, legitimately over 21, I went up and had a little bit, not very much. I'm not very used to booze, though, so I got tipsy for, I think it was the first time in my life I've ever been anywhere near drunk. But then I went from the Foxes and Peppers show straight down to the rave, and that really helped my headache, I've got to tell you. I ended up flat on my back over on the side of the rave trying to get out of the way of all the dancers. And this big blue and yellow fox comes over and asks me if I'm okay, and he gives me a hug. That was definitely the best hug that I've had all the convention.
That's super cute. besides my husband being a first year, because I get to hug him all the time, that doesn't really count. So,
nope.
I think the cotton candy Connor panda was probably my favorite, because he smelled really good. He was the only one that smelled really good, because everyone else is like super sweaty and gross.
I just like the horde. You kind of gathered all of them. You're like, all right, take a picture. All right, give her a hug. And I was like, really? And they all just kind of like swamped me. And I was like, oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I did a maneuver that I did at MFF. This is when I was partially drunk, though, at MFF. So I tried to do this again when I was sober. It wasn't as, I wasn't super successful, but it kind of worked out. I don't know. Were you with me, Punya, when I did those?
Which
ones? I'm like, get in the picture, get in the picture. And everyone like kind of gets together in the picture.
I don't recall.
Okay. So I do this thing where I'm at a convention and I basically just yell at all the fursuiters that are in the hallway and I keep piling them left and right and I don't stop until I have a substantial wall of fursuiters and then I'm like, get in there and take a picture with them, Kia. And she goes in there and just gets this picture with all these random like fursuiters. And then I'm like, all right, now act all sexy. Now do a giant fursuit pile. I'm like, and that's it. And I'm like, now if you stick with me, this is how all pictures happen. So
that's great.
Totally like spacious kind of goes like, I'm gonna be a director for a sec. Okay, you over there. No, you get back over here. You're taking this dang picture. You over there. Picture time. You. And they're all just like, what? Huh? Okay. All right. Cool. They all kind of gather like, okay, cool. All kind of gathering three or four pictures. And they're like, Kia, get in there. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Cool.
I don't even give her an option. I'm like, get in there.
Get in there. Okay. Here I go. Don't listen to space before space goes crazy.
And then, like, I heard one of the fursuiters like, man, he's demanding. And I'm like, damn right, I'm gay.
Sassy face.
I was like, please. This is the first I've had this many fursuiters around me. Just give me a hug. Create a line. Do something. Please. I hugged, like, three of them. And then the rest kind of, like, just dispersed because I, like, didn't want space to say anything else. They're just like, okay, picture done. Good. Awesome. Cool. Bye.
It was good. The next question, how much longer do you have, Punya?
I should actually probably be going.
Okay, we'll do like one more question then.
Okay.
With you. We'll do one more question. We're going to go up to Sona Artist, which I know is Rebel Savant because they've changed their name several times. what two characters would you like to see made into a fursona / original character? Go.
Two creatures. I don't know. That's hard to say because I have a lot of my own original characters that are kind of like unique in their own way. So, yeah. I don't know if that counts. They're already made into creature/OCs.
All my creations are hybrids, so they're not, I mean, they're in their own characters themselves.
I think the one that I was always find fascinating, I like the Aztec type thing, so I've always been all about the Quetzalcoatl type stuff. And then I've always been like, alright, Quetzalcoatl, which is kind of like a giant, you know, dragon snake or just a snake in general with wings. And I was like, all right, now let's mold this together with a griffin. And you kind of get a cool combination. I got bored one day, and I had these two different characters. One was a Quetzalcoatl, and one's a griffin. And I was like, what if they had babies?
What if they had babies?
Well, I actually drew up two characters, and I was like, yay, you have more snake-like features, and you have more griffin-like features. But they had, like, a really nice combination. I was like, you take this one, got the eyes from this, but, you know, the wings from this. And I just kind of, like, molded them together, and I was like, oh, this is actually kind of cool.
I would want to put together... I want to make a red panda gator. Or that a red panda dial.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool.
Pandile.
I've only got the one character. And he's already my persona, so... Jeez. Good question, whoever asked that.
You've been stumped.
Every single animal ever. That would be a hybrid between every single animal ever. That would be the best character ever. Best persona ever.
Freakiest looking persona I've ever seen. It would all just be like, I don't even know how that would look.
You've got to have everything in there, from blue whale to space whales. You've got amoebas and get everything.
Amoeba. I just thought about, like, the water bear, the little water bear, that tiny little microscopic water bear. I used to love that. Every time that came on TV and on Animal Planet, I was like, the water bear, yay! It looks like a weird caterpillar, but it's got, like, six little legs. I'm like, yay!
It's like a caterpillar gummy bear.
Yes! Exactly.
I think mine would be a floppy-eared bunny mixed with a pizzly, which is it's an actual mated species, a grizzly bear and a polar bear that's been speciesed together. So now it's a hybrid. It's a real hybrid, which is even cooler. So like a floppy-eared bunny with a pizzly. I think that'd be cute.
Mm-hmm. That would be the most fluffiest tail ever.
So cute.
The fluffy cotton tail.
It'd be like the biggest cotton tail.
Yes.
Well, folks, that is it for the end of the show. We've gone over a little bit longer than we normally would. I do appreciate both our guests, Matthew and Kia, coming on to our show at the last end of it. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you for media.
You're welcome. we do this. We'll do like Skype furries where we'll just have random people come on. That's always a fun show. I love those shows so much now.
They are a lot of fun to do.
We should do another one soon because those are fun.
Sure.
But we thank everyone for joining up. I'll have this online as soon as I can. Other than that, folks, we thank you for attending. And I've got a shat ton of artists that we're going to be featuring, and I'll be getting in contact soon. So everyone have a wonderful evening, and thanks for watching.
Woo! Good night.
Night.